Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. Let's dive into the acid-catalyzed hydrolysis mechanism for acid derivatives. On the screen, we have the starting materials, reagents, reaction intermediates, and final products for the hydrolysis of an ester in the top left, to a carboxylic acid on the bottom left, and an alcohol on the middle left, or the bottom middle. Let's walk through this process, provide the mechanism arrows, and give some commentary. First, I'll note that many of the mechanisms in first semester chemistry involve strong nucleophiles. Mechanisms with strong nucleophiles tend to be shorter. Mechanisms with weak nucleophiles often involve acid, as we'll see. Acid-catalyzed mechanisms have a lot of steps that just move around protons. I'm trying to prepare you mentally for a long mechanism. Hang in there, we'll get through it. All right, step one for almost any acid-catalyzed reaction is to protonate something. In carbonyl chemistry, we'll always protonate the carbonyl. So, let's use our functional acid, hydronium, to protonate the carbonyl. What we've done is convert our weakly electrophilic ester carbonyl into a strong electrophile. This will now react with even weak nucleophiles, namely water, which is what we have in the reaction. So we'll attack with water. We're breaking the CO pi bond, so this is an addition reaction. It's a nucleophilic addition. The next step is hard to see, in my opinion. Let's go down to the bottom left and look at our final product, the acid. It doesn't have an OCH3 group, so our goal is to get rid of that OCH3 group. Under acidic conditions, we need to protonate groups to make them better leaving groups. Great, let's protonate the OCH3 group. There's one problem. Our current intermediate, is already protonated. So fine, we have to do this the hard way. The next step will be to deprotonate the bottom oxygen. That gives us a neutral molecule. Once it's neutral, we can protonate the OCH3, which is what we wanted to do, to make it a better leaving group. Okay, now the OCH3 is part of a better leaving group. It will now leave, but it doesn't just leave. It sort of gets pushed out. It gets pushed out by this neighboring oxygen. So as we break the CO bond, we form a different new CO pi bond. Breaking bonds requires additional energy, and we'll offset that lost energy by making a new bond at the same time. That was an important step because we lost our alcohol, which is one of our two products. Now let's finish our reaction. Our current intermediate looks just like our product acid, except for it has an extra proton. We'll use water to deprotonate and get our final carboxylic acid. Congratulations, you have conquered the hydrolysis of an acid derivative, specifically an ester. The mechanism of the other acid derivatives is very similar. They all involve protonation first, move around protons so you can lose the right group, and then deprotonate at the end.